Hello everyone. Today we are going to start with next topic, which is power MOSFET and IGBT. In this lecture, we are going to cover power MOSFET and IGBT. Myself, Professor Amit Kumar Mishra. I am having total 10 years of teaching experience and my domain expertise is of also 10 years. Let's start with power MOSFET. First of all, MOSFET stands for Metal Oxide Semiconductor Field Effect Transistor, or we also call it as Metal Oxide Field Effect Transistor. It is a unipolar transistor which acts as a voltage-controlled current device and is a device in which current at two electrodes, drain and source, is controlled by the action of an electric field at another electrode gate having in between semiconductor and metal very a thin metal oxide layer. MOSFET has a very high input impedance due to silicon dioxide layer. It has four terminals, gate, drain, source, and body. Body always connected to source, so it looks like three terminal device like BJT. Now, question arises, why an enhancement type is more common? It is common because we know that as compared to P-type, N is always preferred, and why N is always preferred? Because higher mobility of electrons. Next is types of power MOSFET. So there are two types of power MOSFET. One is depletion type, another one is enhancement type. Now what is depletion type? So you can see one structure over here. So there are two layer N positive and in between that there is a channel. So in depletion type, initially the channel exists and as we biased it and we increase the voltage, this channel, it reduces. So we can see it get depleted. So the name has been given as depletion mode power MOSFET. Now what is enhancement type? In enhancement type, there is no channel initially exists between these two and positive layer. But as we bias it and we increase this bias voltage, the channel get created. So it enhances the conductivity because of creation of channel. So the name has been given as enhancement type. Both type of power MOSFET are of two type. One is N channel, another one is P channel. Symbol of power MOSFET. So for N channel power MOSFET or E MOSFET enhancement type, arrow is inward, and for P channel, arrow is outward. Whereas the terminals are same, whether it's N channel or P channel, gate, drain, and source. Let's see the operation of power MOSFET in detail. This is a power MOSFET, this is gate, this is drain, and this is source. Initially, there is no channel exists between these two N layers. So this is enhancement type. As we are going to give the gate voltage across gate terminal, this positive terminal of the gate voltage is getting connected with the P layer. So what will happen? This positive terminal of the gate voltage is going to repel the holes and going to attract the minority carriers in this P layer, which is electron toward itself. As we increase this VGG, more electrons will get accumulated over here. Once this VGG become greater than VGG threshold or VGS threshold, a complete N layer get created between these two N layer. So we can say channel creation takes place. Now after that, we have to give VDD. So in this way, if we supply the VDD, what will happen? This positive terminal of the battery of VDD will attract the electrons from this N layer. So electrons will start moving upward. And negative terminal of the battery VDD will repel the electrons in the bottom N layer. So these electrons will get repelled from this negative terminal of the battery and hence electrons will move upward. So due to this battery VDD, electron from this layer moving upward and electron from this layer moving on this side. So movement of electron takes place in this direction. We know that current flows in the opposite direction of the current, opposite direction of the electrons. So as electrons are moving in this direction, current will flow in this direction. Or we can say electrons are moving in clockwise direction, so the current will flow in anti-clockwise direction. This current, which is flowing through this device, is ID, that is drain current, or we call it as IDS, that is drain to source current. Let's see the characteristics of power MOSFET. This characteristic has been plotted between drain current versus drain to source voltage. Now, drain current to drain to source voltage means what? As we are increasing this drain voltage, what is the effect of that on drain current? So in this characteristic, there are three regions. One is cutoff, another one is linear, and third one is saturation. When there is no channel creation takes place, that means VGG or VGS is less than VGS threshold, the device will remain in cutoff. Why? Because there is no channel, so there is no flow of current takes place. So this region is cutoff region. Now once channel has been created, after that we are giving this supply VDD. So what will happen, this VDD, because of this VDD, ID will start flowing through this circuit. So this VDD is directly proportional to the drain current ID. So you can see over here, as we are increasing this VDD or VDS, drain current vary proportional to that. So this is linear region. This is linear region. Now next is saturation region. What is saturation region? So once this VDD become greater than a particular voltage, after that drain current become constant. That means if we increase this VDD beyond that voltage, there is no effect of VDD or VDS on this drain current. So that value of voltage of VDD beyond which drain current become constant is called as VP, that is pinch off voltage. So this is saturation region, and this point, the value of this voltage at this point is called as pinch off voltage. The current become constant over here. This indicates saturation region, or we can say active region. Next characteristic is transfer characteristic. This characteristic is between VGS versus ID. That means if we are increasing gate voltage, what is the effect of that on gate current? So initially there is no channel, so the device will remain in cutoff. There is no current flow through that. Once this VGS is greater than VGS threshold, drain current will start flowing through it. We have one term, that is IDS, that is drain to source current, which is also called as drain current. So this IDS is equal to IDSS into 1 minus VGS upon VGS of square. That means this drain to source current is given by this equation, where IDSS is drain current when VGS is zero. VGS off is defined as minus of VP. We know that VP is pinch off voltage above which drain current become constant. Data sheet of power MOSFET. So this is one example of power MOSFET. The name of this power MOSFET is IRF540. This is N-channel power MOSFET. Various parameters of this is VDSS, that is drain to source voltage with shorted gate, is 100 volt. Drain to source resistance is 0.077 ohm and drain current is 28 ampere. Gate driver circuit of power MOSFET. This is again important. MOSFET is having a gate terminal. We need to give a gate a pulse so that the device will get triggered. That pulse should have a minimum width, or we can say we can give a spike of pulse. So how that pulse get produced? So there are two circuits for that. One is this circuit, another one is this circuit. In this circuit, first we have used 555 IC555 timer. So IC555 timer will produce a rectangular, or we can say square wave across its output, which is third pin. This square wave is fed to these two transistor Q1 and Q2, which is acting like a push-pull. So this will convert this square wave into spikes. And this spike is fed to the gate of power MOSFET, and hence power MOSFET will get triggered. Second is this circuit. Here we had given a logic level gate pulse, which is fed to this Q3 and later on fed to these two transistor Q1 and Q2. So the pulse which is going to produce is going to fed to the power MOSFET, and power MOSFET will get triggered. We have another characteristic. This is safe operating area of power MOSFET. Basically any device is there. Let's talk about power MOSFET only. It operates with the maximum, it can operate or tolerate maximum current, maximum voltage and maximum power. If these parameters goes beyond maximum value, the device will get damaged. So this is maximum value of gate, maximum value of collector current, or we can say drain current. which is flowing through the circuit. This is voltage limit and this is maximum power. So if we plot this curve, device should operate in this region only, and this region is called as safe operating area. Let's see merits, demerits, and applications of power MOSFET. First of all, merits of power MOSFET. MOSFETs are majority carriers devices. MOSFETs have positive temperature coefficient, hence their paralleling is easy. MOSFETs have very simple drive circuits. MOSFETs have short turn on and off times, hence they operate at high frequencies. MOSFETs do not require commutation techniques. Gate has full control over the operation of MOSFET. Demerits of MOSFET. On-state losses in MOSFET are high. MOSFETs are used only for low power applications, and MOSFETs suffer from static charges. Applications of power MOSFET. First is high frequency and low power inverters. Second is high frequency SMPS. Third is high frequency inverters and choppers. And the last one is low power AC and DC drives. Let's start with the next topic, which is IGBT. We know that BJT has low on-state power loss, but as a switch, it is slower. And MOSFET has high on-state power loss, but as a switch, it is faster. So what we are going to do is we are going to combine these two devices, BJT and MOSFET. From BJT, we will take the characteristic of on-state power loss, which is low. And from MOSFET, we will take the characteristic of switching, which is faster. And we'll form another device, which is called as IGBT, insulated gate bipolar transistor. Other names of IGBT are IGT, that is insulated gate transistor, and COMFET, that is conductivity modulated field effect transistor. This is the structure of IGBT. Like we have seen, there are BJTs are there as well as MOSFET is there. So we can see in the internal structure of that, there are two BJTs. This is PNP, this is NPN, and one MOSFET is there. Or through this also we get to know the same. There are three terminals in that: emitter, gate, and collector. Structure of IGBT, as we are going through that, vertical oriented structure to maximize the area for current flow. This will reduce the resistance and hence on-state power loss. The main difference in structure of IGBT as compared to MOSFET is P-positive layer forms drain of IGBT. N-negative drift layer to improve its breakdown voltage capacity. IGBT made up of N-positive buffer layer and they termed as asymmetric. This layer improves operation by means it reduces on-state voltage drop across device, shortens the turn-off time. Buffer layer reduces reverse blocking capacity of IGBT. There are two types of IGBT. One is non-punch through. In that, N positive layer is absent. N punch through. That is N positive layer is present. This is N positive. So this is punch through IGBT. Characteristics of IGBT. So if we see the first graph, this is the characteristic between collector voltage versus collector current. That means collector to emitter voltage versus collector current. So there are three regions of operation. First is cutoff, another one is linear, and third one is active or saturation. So which is almost same as that of power MOSFET. Initially, there is no current, so device will remain in cutoff. After that, as we increase VCE, collector current will flow and that current will be almost linear, or we can say proportional to the collector current. Therefore, the device is called as ohmic region, or it will be in linear region. And third is pinch off or saturation region. Once VCE crosses a particular value of voltage, which is pinch off voltage, collector current becomes constant. So that current will be, that region will be saturation region. Second characteristic is transfer characteristic. This is gate voltage versus collector current. Means if we are increasing the gate voltage, what is the effect on the circuit current? So initially there will be no current, but as we increase the gate voltage, collector current will start flowing. So So the same, initially there is no current, and once VG voltage, VGE is greater than VGE threshold, collector current will start flowing through the device. Let's see the comparison between power MOSFET and IGBT. First parameter of comparison is construction. In power MOSFET, injecting layer P positive is absent. In IGBT, injecting layer P positive is present to increase the conductivity. Current conduction. Current conduction is due to only majority carriers, hence it is unipolar. In IGBT, current conduction is due to both majority and minority carriers, hence it is bipolar. Input impedance. Power MOSFET, it is high. In IGBT, it is lower. Switching times. In power MOSFET, T on and T off are very small. In IGBT, T on and T off are larger. Switching frequency. In power MOSFET, it is very high. In IGBT, it is low. On state resistance. Power MOSFET, it is larger due to drift layer. In IGBT, it is smaller due to N positive layer. And the last is on state losses. Losses are more in power MOSFET. Basically, the range is 2 volts to 5 volts. And in IGBT, losses are less. It is between 1 volt to 1.5 volts. This is figure of IGBT. Let's take an example. This is of CM100DU12F, where 100 indicates 100 ampere rating. DU for dual mode. Dual mode means there will be two IGBT. And what is 12? 12 for 1200 volts. These are the field where IGBT are used, various applications of IGBT we can say. It is used in home appliances, servo motors, welders, inverters, solar wind power generator, power distribution, traction, UPS, dual mode, e-auto, etc., etc. So in this lesson, we have learned power MOSFET and IGBT. Thank you.